2009. They were one of the biggest rock names in the 1980s with a string of top 10 hits, including Don't You Forget About Me and Belfast Child. Now, Simple Minds are back with their 16th studio album.
So how hard is it to write another album when you've been in the business 3 decades? We'll be asking the band singer Jim Kerr and guitarist Charlie Burchill in a moment. First, though, let's have a look back at some of their greatest hits.
Jim and Charlie from Simple Minds are with us now. And if you need to adjust your set, the vertical hold or the horizontal, Jim's got just the coat for
getting
it.
My money's worth, boy. Bought at Christmas. And
everybody who's watching High Definition is going to be going there saying, what's the matter? What's going wrong?
I know.
It's because he saw me this morning. He wanted
exactly.
to match, wasn't it?
We're in sync.
Good to see you anyway.
Lovely to see you both. I want to talk about the new single, Let the Day Begin. We'll see a clip of it in a moment. But the fans contributed to the video, did they? Is that right?
They did, yeah. Through the website and the social networks, we thought, we'd rather see their faces than ours. And they would rather see their faces than ours. So we asked people to show how their day began, and so all over the world, people sit in little clips of what they did first thing in the morning.
Wow. And let's see what they do first thing in the morning. Here we go.
I think we could change it, couldn't we?
We won't complain about that.
Yeah, yeah.
16 albums on Den, and you had rave reviews for this one, but I read earlier that you almost ran out of inspiration at one point, did you? Did you sort of think, oh, crikey,
Charlie didn't, but I did.
You did?
Probably about 10 years ago, there was a period where you start to think, well, I wonder, sometimes it did feel like getting blood out of stone, but I'm glad to say that we stuck by it. And
how did you find your mojo again?
It found me. I think what it is you find space in your life for the music to become the most important thing. I mean, the age Charlie and I are, our kids are grown up now, and all that other stuff that had to be dealt with it's cut us some slack. Yeah. So we made the music the most important thing, and I think that's what people are feeling with a new record.
Okay. And Charlie, you didn't lose your inspiration at all then?
No, I never really had that moment. I was just sort of... I'm too technical. I loved all the equipment and just playing around with the gear. So
The sound is unmistakably Simple Minds. I mean, you listen to the album, it could not be remotely anybody...
Thanks. That's a great thing.
But I was intrigued that you, with your recording techniques, you're big fans of analog. Is that
rare,
right?
Not
digital. So how does that work?
Well, I think we've changed now. We like both, actually, to be honest. And in this day and age, you've got to employ everything, But we worked with 3 different people on this album, and they all had their own individual ways of being able to, bring something to the...
Should people be buying this album on vinyl? I don't know if it's available on vinyl. Should they go and get it on vinyl?
It'll sound better.
If they've got a record player, yes.
You can't survive them.
If not, it's got a nice sleeve.
Yeah.
But
well, they can put a code reader to your coat to be honest.
Well, it's a good point, Bill. Actually, it sounds fantastic on vinyl. It really does. Obviously, we tour a lot, so we can't really, you know, carry our record players around with us. Mm. But given the chance, the vinyl does sound good.
And given a chance at home, is that what you would play records on, vinyl, then?
Play anything to be honest, whatever. Play it in the bath. And we grew up listening to a tinny little radio and it sounded great. So I think if it's a good song, it'll come across.
You mentioned that you love performing live and you're going on this enormous tour, but to some interesting places, unusual places, like Grimsby, Bridlington Spa.
What's unusual about Grimsby?
Well, it's not if you live there.
It's not,
it's a lovely place, but it's not on your standard arena tour route.
You're right. Well, we have got two modes of touring. We do the arenas, which means that normally, as you say, you do the major cities, but, you know, you go through the UK in a week and a half, or else you can say, let's go to all the places we used to play when we're starting out. And we're now, you know, we tour 5-6 weeks in the UK, and we love it because apart from getting to the audiences that are out the way, a lot of these old venues are fantastic. They've been refurbished, you know, they're back to their glory. You go to Leicester, you go to Ipswich, you go to Perth. Our favourite gig is Blackpool. You know, you go backstage and there's a huge poster of Ken Dodd.
Yeah.
You think we've got a lot to live up to.
Plays long gigs, doesn't he?
Yeah, he locks you in, yeah.
And what about, what songs do you play? Do you play a whole mixture or how does it work for
Evidence. Yeah, we're going to do it's in two parts. And first half we might do most of the last 10 years, and then second half we'll do everything that people would really.
And you don't play the same set, do you?
Half and half. It's probably about 12 songs we feel we have to play.
Right.
And when I say we feel we have to play, I mean that in a positive sense. You know, there's songs
they'd be disappointed if you
didn't. But then there's a hardcore who say, we're fed up hearing that. You know, we want to hear this. So a good set kind of appeals to everybody. And that's a challenge. But it's a great challenge to have. And usually by the end of the night, everyone's jumping
obviously
up and down.
The sound check's obviously different for the different places that you go to. But do you... Is there a difference in approach when you know that you're going to be playing a cosier hall as opposed to a great big arena?
Yeah, in fact, we did a tour about 2 years ago, similar tour to this. It was the theatres. And we did the arenas about 6 or 7 months later. And the first time we went to the sound check, Jim and I's hearts sank because it was like people with hard hats and...
The energy sort of dissipated.
It's kind of, you know, the intimacy of the theatres is fantastic.
I think in truth we like them all, but as you say, they are different challenges.
Mm. Well, I hope you have fun on your tour, especially
thank
in Grimsby.
Grimsby and Manchester as well, of course, we're here looking forward to that.
Yeah, oh, good.
Lovely to see you both.
Good to see you.
Thank you very much. A Simple Minds start touring next month.